Hey, Chapel Field families, I hope all is well with you as we've now launched out into summer. Now that the closing ceremonies are over, we had a great graduation a week and a half ago. Sad, but great to send our seniors off. So proud of them. Looking forward to what the Lord will do in their lives in the years to come. Now that classes are over and final exams are done and everything's wrapped up, we just hope that you all are having a great summer. I don't think you could have written a crazier 2020 thus far. And we know how desperately we all need refreshment. And so I hope that you are having time with your family and a good time to refresh yourselves as we get ready for next year. Now, I know none of us want to be thinking about the fall. And yet at the same time, we all are because we know that the coming year is loaded with uncertainties. So I wanted to make sure that I reached out to you and just gave you some sense of our thoughts with regards to the coming year. Again, hard to give details because we know much will change between now and September. And of course, a lot of what we decide will depend on what the state regulates and demands by law. So we'll have to wait on those things. But nonetheless, we wanted to give you some idea of what we were thinking. Now, first of all, and I reminded our faculty of this, we just had our year-end meeting the other day, to remember what we're about. Not to lose focus in the midst of all of the craziness, in the midst of all of the distraction. To remember that what we're about is the academic, spiritual, and social thriving of our students, of your children. And we're here to partner with you for the sake of your children, for their Christian education. Now, we have to plan, and so I want to give you some idea of our plans. Number one, we are planning for full open in the fall. Inasmuch as it depends on us, we will be ready for that. Inasmuch as the state allows it, we will be ready for full open on campus in the fall with as many of our full-time students as is possible for as many days of the week as is possible. We're hoping for 5 days a week, full days of school. That's what we're preparing for. And we're preparing to do that in the most healthy, responsible, and safe ways. We've already had a shipment, an order of cleaning supplies come in so that we can plan for our cleaning regimens. And we'll detail all those for you as we get closer to the school year and know exactly what we're looking at. We're also throwing ideas around about how to be as creative as we can with our campus, whatever that means, how we can work to space students out. How can we use our outdoor facilities? How can we use the outside so that we can get students out in open space as much as possible, especially while the weather's good in the early fall? We're also looking at how to be creative with our schedules so that we can, limit the constant interaction of the students and be responsible with them in their space. So again, the plan is for full open as much as we're able. At the same time, we're planning the contingency plans. So we're planning the hybrid sessions also. How can we do partial on campus and partial virtual? If the state does not allow us to have all of our students on campus at the same time, we're already working through different scenarios where we could provide on-campus education and virtual education at the same time, remote learning. So we're prepared for that. And then finally, if need be, we're prepared to do, once again, full remote learning if we need to. And we're prepared to double down on the things that work well, and we're looking with a very critical eye at the things that we could have done better. We've been discussing this with our faculty, and also we'll be anxious to hear from you. We had a survey back in earlier spring to see what you thought was working well and what wasn't, and hopefully we'll be reaching out in the weeks to come to see again, to hear from you. Ultimately, our desire is to provide the best possible education in challenging circumstances like that for you and your kids. And if something's not working well, we don't want to do it. If there's something we can do better, we will. If it comes to that, our emphasis will be on personal contact with our faculty and the students to make sure that we're reaching out to them to give as much individual attention as we possibly can. And I was proud of our teachers and the work they did this past spring to that end, as they reached out via emails, as they reached out via Zoom, even some of them making calls to the families to make sure that they could deal with particular needs that students had. So we'll be doubling down on that should we have to go remote. And also working on smaller group education. So yes, we did Zoom calls with the whole class, but we'll be also looking to do sort of small group sessions where a teacher can be 1-on-5, 1-on-8, smaller group, give more individual attention throughout the week. So that's the plan, some of the plans, should we need to go full remote. In the end, whatever scenario, we will be prepared, and we want to let you know that we're on it and we're here for you and here with you to accomplish the education of your children together. We believe in many ways that Chapel Field exists for occasions just like this. We're here to partner with you so that families are not alone in the education of their children, but rather with the family, the church, and then the school, all three together reinforcing one another's work. We can give the kids the best possible Christian education we can. At the end of the day, we know you want to raise sturdy kids, resilient kids. I love that phrase, sturdy kids. We heard it in a lecture at the conference, a virtual conference that our faculty attended last weekend. We want to raise sturdy kids, kids who can face trials and tribulations, children who love the Lord Jesus Christ and who trust their sovereign God, who know that their sovereign God does not shield his people from trials and tribulations, but rather leads them into trial and through trial. That their God equips them for the trials he leads them into. He preserves them in the midst of them and provides for them in the midst of them. And ultimately, he grows his children through those trials to make them into the men and the women that he wants them to be. We do this by studying the scriptures. We do this by reading great stories. Chapel Field pre-K through 12 puts the best stories in front of our children so that our students emulate the great heroes of these stories and their virtues, their courage, their fortitude, their perseverance, and their patience. That's what our students are taught to do in the great stories that they read. We want students who hunger and thirst, whose hearts and souls long for the good, the true, and the beautiful things. This is our aim. This is our mission. This is what we're about, to partner with parents to help raise these kinds of kids. And I want to assure you that there is nothing that will come in the fall that will keep us from meeting that mission and fulfilling that aim. We are here with you and here to accomplish that. Look for the email that is to follow. It'll detail as much as we're able to detail. I want to let you know also that you're able to reach out to me at any time. You can email me at b.spanger@chapelfield.org. If you have questions, I will give you as much detail as we can. Or feel free to call the office. Also, in the email that's coming, look for some summer offers. Our faculty, many of our faculty are available to be tutors for your students, upper school, either in STEM or humanities, grammar school, in any of the subjects we want to provide. If you feel like your student needs a little booster to get themselves ready for the coming year, our faculty are available for that. Also, look, as we'll be providing some reading lists. Parents, especially grammar school parents, there's nothing better you can do for the continuing education and development of your children than to read out loud to them. And so we'll provide some suggestions if you don't have ideas already, and for them to read on their own also. And then look for us to run some summer get-togethers. We'll be doing maybe some reading groups, either on campus or via Zoom, and also maybe some fun get-togethers, some short-term camps, either athletic or art get-togethers. We're working on painting and drawing, or maybe playing some sports together. So anyway, we'll list out some of those possibilities in the email also. Well, ultimately, the reason I reached out to you via video was to let you know that whatever comes in the fall, we're on it. And we'll give you as much detail as we can. And also to let you know that we love you, we love your family, we love your children, and that we're praying for you all. May the Lord give you a wonderful summer. As best as you can, set aside the problems of the fall and let your souls just be refreshed together as a family over the time of this summer. So we look forward to seeing you, and especially to seeing your children on campus, Lord willing, in the fall. May the Lord bless you all and give you a wonderful summer.